Pulsary means another is this called use of flow device. It is used to measuring the rate of flow of a fluid device. It is cheaper device when compared with pressure. When compared to pressure, it is cheaper device. It consists of a flat circular plate with a circular sharp edge hole called as orifice, which is concentric with pipe. It consists of a flat plate. It consists of a flat plate, has a circular pipe edge. Now this is a diagram. This is a diagram. Diagram consists of orifice plate here, which consists of an sharp edges. Now pipe diameter P is the diameter, flow is flowing inside the pipe. And now the flow has been taking place, it has been discharges. The water has been goes on discharge. This is called as orifice diameter. This orifice diameter is diameter. The where it has been reduces, the water has been reduced, that's called as vena contracta. Yes, vena contracta. Pressure drop across the orifice H, where your differential manometer is connected, there may be occurring of pressure drop. That where the pressure reduces, that is called as vena contracta. Okay, that is called as vena contracta. Next, a differential manometer is connected at section 1, which has distance between 1.5 meter and 2 times of pipe diameter, which is the distance about 1.5 meter and 2.5 pipe diameter upstream from the orifice plate. And the section 2, which is at distance of about half of the diameter of the orifice on the downstream of the orifice plate. Those are the measurements of orifice plates, orifice meters. Let P1 is the pressure at section 1, P1 is the velocity at section 1, A1 is the area of pipe at section 1, D2, P2, V2, A2 be the corresponding values of section 2. Next comes next slide. Now, venturimeters are generally used placed in approximately horizontal positions. That means Z1 is equal to Z2. When our Z1 is equal to Z2, using the Bernoulli's equation, P1 by rho g plus V1 square by rho g plus P2 by rho g, V2 square by rho g, by Z1, Z2 remains cancelled. Next, we get P1 by rho g by taking pressure terms on one side, P1 terms on one side, and velocity terms on another side. We get P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g minus V2 square by rho g minus V1 square by 2G. Now, H is equals to, H can be written as V1 square by 2G, velocity head V2 square by 2G minus of V1 square by 2G is equals to H. But from continuity equation, we know that Q is equals to A1, V1 is equals to A2, V2. Whenever A1, V1 is equals to A2, V2, V1 is equals to V2 multiplied with A2 by A2 divided by A1. Now, substitution H is equals to V2 square minus, in place of V1, substitute V2 square into A1, A2, A2 by A1 whole square. We get after calculation V2 square multiplied with 1 minus of A2 square minus of A1 square is equal to 2GH. V2 square is equal to, by taking on that side, becomes multiplication 2GH by 1 minus A2 square minus of A1 square. Now 2GH, by taking the denominator upwards, numerator upwards, that is A1 square minus of A2 square minus of A1 square divided by A2 square minus A1 square. Now V2 is equal to square root of this value, A1 by root of A2 square minus of A1 square into root 2GH, where A2, we know that Q is equal to A1 A2 divided by root of A1 square minus of A2 square into root 2GH. Now section 2 is vena contracta, there may be small changes, vena contracta is there. A2 is replaced by area of vena contracta. Only small change. Now if A0 is the orifice area, then we have CC is equals to A2 divided by A0. Coefficient of contraction. Coefficient of contraction is nothing but vena contracta. A2 divided by A0. Coefficient of contraction, from that A2 is equals to A0 into CC. By substitution, Q is equals to A1 A0. That A2 place, in place of A2, A0 into CC divided by root of A1 square minus of A0 into CC whole square multiplied with root 2GH. is equals to CD multiplied with A0 A1 of 1 minus of A1 A0 square minus of A1 square into root 2 GH. Now Q is equals to CD into A0 A1 root 2 GH by root of A1 square minus of A0 square. Now CD is called as coefficient of discharge. CD is called as coefficient of discharge. Next, continuation problems on odd phase meters. We are using this formula. Q is equals to Q actual is equals to this actual formula. Q actual is equals to CD into A0 A1 root of 2 GH by root of A1 square minus of A0 square. Problems on odd phase meter. Odd phase meter with odd phase diameter 10 cm is inserted in a pipe of 20 cm diameter. The pressure gauge is fitted upstream and downstream of odd phase meter. Use the reading of 19.62 Newton per centimeter square and 9.81 Newton per centimeter square respectively. Coefficient of discharge odd phase meter is given as 0.6. Find the discharge of water to pipe. Now diameter of odd phase is given, D0 is equal to 10 cm. 10 cm means 0.1. Area of inlet A0 is equal to pi by 4 D square, pi by 4 D0 square. It is pi by 4 0.1 square. You get value. Next, diameter of pipe D1 is equal to 20 cm, that is equal to 0.2 meters. Now, area of pipe is equal to pi by 4 D square, pi by 4 0.2. So, we have calculated the values. Next, pressure at inlet is given as 19.62 meter per centimeter square. Convert them into newton per meter square. 9.62 into 10 power 4 meter per meter square. Pressure at outlet P2 is equal to 9.81 newton per centimeter square. That is 9.81 into 10 power 4 meter per meter square. Solution. Head of water at R phase. H1 is equal to P1 by rho g. P1 is 19.62 into 10 power 4 divided by OG 1000, G is 9.827. Head of water at inlet H2 is equal to P2 by rho G minus P2 by rho G is equal to P2 is 9.81 into 10 power 4 divided by rho 1000 9.81. Now total head of water H is equal to H1 minus H2. This P1 by rho G minus P2 by rho G. From that H is equal to 20 minus 10. 10 meter of water. Now, total head of water H is equal to 10 meter of water. 10 meter of water means 10 into 100, you get in terms of 1000 centimeter of water. Using the discharge equation Q, by equation Q, Q is equal to CD into A0 A1 root of 2GH by root of A1 square minus of A1 square. Now, Q is equal to 0.6 into A0 is 78.4, A1 is 314.6. Root of 2 into 9.81 divided by root of 314.16 square minus 7.78.4 square. That Q is equal to discharge, Q is equal to terms of centimeter cube per second, 68213.28 centimeter cube. By using this formula, we are finding out the discharge. That is the way in order to solve the problems on or phase meter. Now, what is the major difference between venturi meter and odd phase meters? In venturi meter, first should be fabrication. Fabrication of venturi meter should be very difficult. Fabrication of venturi meter is difficult. It is fitted to a pipe itself. It is very difficult, very technical itself. Next one, head loss or insufficient. There may be less head losses. Reading of venturi meter is small under identical conditions. Reading of venturi meter is small under identical conditions. CD is lies between 0.6 to 0.99. The lies of CD coefficient of discharge is 0.6 to 0.99. Comes to orifice meters. Come to fabrication is very technical here. The easy to install. The installment is very easy. We can change by time to time. Only the plate is changed. Head loss are known. There may be so much head loss due to the vena contraction. Next, reading of R phase meter is larger under identical condition. Reading of R phase meter is larger under identical conditions. Now CD is less between 0.6 to 0.6. And this is the about R phase meter derivation, R phase meter problems, and the difference between the R phase meter as well as the venturi meters.